Good morning everyone. So in this video we are going to discuss about the system concepts like state controllability and Kalman controllability as well as Gilbridge law controllability. So these things we are going to discuss over here. Okay. So first we are going to discuss about state controllability. So is it possible to transfer the system under the consideration from any initial state to desired state by the application suitable control force with specified time? Is it possible to determine the initial states of the system if the output vector is known as finite length of time? Okay, so the answer for these questions we can justify the using of controllability and observability. So mainly this controllability and observability is used for the any initial state, desired state application suitable for the control force for in specified time. So for that we are going to check in and also determine the initial states of the system output vector known for the finite length of time. So to checking for this we have used for the controllability and observability here. The system said to be completely controllable if it is possible for the transfer of the system state from any initial state xt of 0 to any desired state xt of in a specified finite interval t naught less than or equal to t less than or equal to tp. Okay, so to is representing here as observability. No, t 0 to less than or equal to t less than or equal to p, so by unconstrained control vector u of t. So otherwise the system is not completely state controllable. Okay, so the next step, the consider the multiple output multiple input linear time variant system represented by its equation is equal to x of t is equal to a x of t into v u of t. So here a is n into n order state matrix, v is the n into m order input matrix, u of t is equal to m into 1 input vector, x of t is equal to n into 1 state vector. Okay, so the state controllability test can be performed by two methods, that is the one for Kalman test for controllability, another one for Gilbert test for controllability. So in this video we are going to discuss about overall information about the Kalman test controllability. The next video we are going to see about the details. So the Kalman test will take, so in this method is applicable for any matrix A, either matrix A is in the canonical form or otherwise. Okay, so that is Kalman's test. Then if you take down the Gilbert test for controllability, Gilbert. Okay, so this method is based on the converting the matrix A into the diagonal canonical form, and later it is used to determine the state controllability of the system. So in the Kalman method it is used for any matrix A, either matrix A is canonical form or otherwise, but here it is matrix A into the diagonal canonical form, and later it is used to determine the state controllability of the system. Then comes into the next, the Kalman test for state controllability. Here the nth order multiple input linear time invariant system represented the state equation like x into ax of t plus du u of t. So here a is n into n order matrix, and controllability qc and the size n into m can be qc is equal to b ab a to b a square b a cube b an minus 1 into b. So this system said to be controllable if the rank of controllability matrix qc n, then the determined order n into n of any sub matrix qc is non-zero. Also the rank of the controllability matrix qc is less than n, then the system is not completely state controllable. So here we have to consider the x dot of t equal to ax of t plus b u of t. So y of t is equal to cx of t plus du of t. So here a and b and d are state space model. So in this one, case one, matrix A is a canonical form. The transformation matrix is the identity matrix T is equal to I. Also that if A1 is equal to A, B1 equal to B, C1 equal to C, B1 equal to D, then controllability can be stated as the system distinct eigenvalues is completely state control dependent. Only the zero element is present in the transform matrix of B. So BT is equal to T power 1 of B. So this is we are going to take first equation. In the second case, the matrix A is not in the diagonal form of canonical form. Following steps are followed. So that is to find the eigenvalue of the matrix A. So modulus of lambda I minus A equal to 0. So here I is equal to identity matrix. So step 2 for in this case 2, find the transformation matrix. So in the transform matrix it will become so like T is equal to B equal to 1 1 1 first one, second is the lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 up to lambda n, and lambda 1 square, lambda 2 square, lambda 3 square, lambda n square, lambda 2 square, lambda 3 square, lambda 1 cube, lambda 2 cube, lambda 3 cube, lambda n cube, like up to lambda n minus 1, lambda 1 of n minus 1, lambda 2 of n minus m minus 1 dot 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 lambda n of n minus 1. So this is called as Vendor-Mond matrix. Then comes into the step 3 of the case 2. Find the transformation matrix AT, BT, CT, DT of the diagonal canonical form is below. So AT is equal to T inverse of AT is equal to diagonal matrix, BT is a T inverse of B, C1 plus CT is equal to C of T, DT is equal to T. So if no row of BT of T inverse B has zero elements, the system completely state controllable. Okay, so this is for the Gilbert test for state controllability. Okay, so in this two cases, okay, so in the first case BT of T is equal to T power 1 of B, in the second case BT of T is equal to T inverse of B, 0 element. So conditions, in the first case the diagonal transformation, the Gilbert controllability stated as the direct eigenvalue vector completely state controllable and zero element present in the transverse B matrix. So the second one, the matrix is not a diagonal canonical following steps are followed. So these are all the things we discussed over here. Thank you.